This movie might be really hard to review. Fresh just released on Hulu, and it's very much worth your time because it's one of my favorite movies of the year so far. Go into this totally blind, though. This movie takes a direction that's intense. I saw this movie at Sundance, and I actually watched it at 2 a.m. because that's when it started, so I was in such a tired headspace. But even being very tired, I was still incredibly engaged and riveted. The way the story progressed here was really interesting to me. It took its time to truly start the plot. I mean, the opening credits don't even start until 30 minutes into the movie, but within those 30 minutes, there's a really great setup for the relationship between our characters Noah and Steve. It feels cute at first, but once it starts to show its true colors, we start to feel the manipulation and terror that Noah feels. Needless to say, I thought the balancing of tones here was fantastic. The movie may start off as a cute little romance, but it also doesn't treat you like an idiot. They throw several hints that something may be off, and then once the shit hits the fan, it never felt out of place. Director Mimi Cave knew exactly what to do to properly structure the story and manipulate the audience. It goes off like a bomb that we never even realized was there. To me, it was pretty easy to figure out that something was off, but I didn't know to what extent they were going to take it. And once it happened, I was fully on board. This is Mimi Cave's directorial debut, and she absolutely nails it. Once this movie actually starts, she does not hold anything back. It is bleak, disturbing, intense, disgusting, hopeless, and it is taking you down with them. But my favorite part of her direction was how she handled the atmosphere of the film. The overall atmosphere and location feels like hell. Just by the sheer look of it, feels so terrifying and empty. Like there's nothing in this space except for you and this devil, and you know something is going to happen to you, but you don't know when, and the way it's lit also gives off a hopeless vibe as well. It's so dim, like you can barely see the area. I love how much attention to detail she gave just for the location alone. Daisy Edgar Jones is fantastic. She sells the terror so well, especially during the scene where everything is being explained to her. She balances the fear, depression, and desperation of her situation so well. But she's also someone who has to think fast a lot of the time in order to get herself out of the situation. She always has some kind of plan and nothing ever stops her. But to me, it's Sebastian Stan who steals the entire movie. The man is seriously becoming quite the fantastic actor. The man commits to every single role that he plays, and he is terrifying throughout this entire thing. His character is like a time bomb. He'll bring a calm and unsettling nature to this character, and then when he explodes, he's impossible to stop. He's so believable in the role, as weird as that sounds. There's a type of energy that he brings to this character that's so bizarre you can't look away from him, the dance scene being the highlight. I may consider this to be one of my favorite movies of the year so far, but it's not my absolute favorite. I do have some problems. First off, there are moments where some pretty dumb decisions were made by the main character. I won't spoil, of course, but it becomes a little frustrating. I get a lot of moments she has to think fast, but you're kind of left there like, why did you do that? It makes up for some satisfying moments with her, though. Another thing is that some things are left unresolved. They'll develop one thing and then it just kind of disappears without any resolution. But the great development, sharp dialogue, amazing direction and atmosphere, great performances, and satisfying ending make this one I think a lot of people will enjoy. I mean, don't watch it with grandma, but it's a great movie to watch with a bunch of friends and just enjoy the wild ride. Yeah, I love this movie. Check it out on Hulu. Thank you guys for watching. Here are my socials, and I have a special video coming out pretty soon. Okay, bye-bye.
And that's the end.